In abandoned baby news.
Oh, that sucks.
Submitted by More Steve, please. Well.
Pow, pow, pow.
They love you, Steve.
Oh, they're the best.
You guys are the best. We love you too. So that's why you're coming in.
I love being here. It's great.
Yep.
A woman left her baby in an airport bathroom with a heartbreaking note.
Oh, no.
What's going on here?
That's very sad.
Mm-hmm.
An airport bathroom.
Is it alive?
The baby's alive.
Okay, good. Oh, I was, okay, okay.
Jokes, can you resume?
Yeah, right, exactly. I was like, ooh.
Well, what did the mom say? I think that's,
yeah. I have a flight and the baby keep crying, sorry.
Oh, Jesus. Oh my God.
I hope you're wrong.
It's like, I'm gonna be late, baby, slowing me down. Like, what do you say?
At that point, you've already passed TSA.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, and they know that that's your baby problem.
Yeah.
Damn.
I know. So we don't know if the woman just landed at the airport or if she was about to take off, but apparently she gave birth in the bathroom.
Oh, fuck, a newbie.
Yeah. And she left the note with the baby boy wrapped in a blanket, and she threw away her bloody clothes in the bathroom trash.
Oh,
and
shit.
So the note, in part, it says, "Please help me. My mom had no idea she was pregnant. She is unable and unfit to take care of me. Please get me to the authorities so they can find me a good home. And then she says, I just want what's best for him, and it's not me. Please, I'm sorry." And so she left the baby in the changing table, you know, the things that pulled out.
The one with the koala logo?
Yeah, that, and she left the baby there.
Good brand, by the way. It stuck in your head, didn't it? It worked, huh?
We don't know the name of the brand.
He's like, everyone make fun of my koala brand, you'll see. We all know it.
You're the only baby changing table that you'll remember,
right?
Have you changed Tyga on those public?
Not yet.
You have?
Dude, you gotta spray those things down or first or something, right?
You come with your own changing.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
So they have surveillance footage of her. They blurred out her face. She's holding the baby.
I can't see nothing, man.
That's in an airport?
Her head is blurred out. Yeah, this is an airport. The Arizona airport.
Look like a Sith Lord.
Oh, it's a Zona airport. Because that's not as busy. I was going to say, if this is LAX, someone's picking up your baby, like, as you're laying it down, they're seeing you pick up your baby.
Yeah. This is in Tucson.
Yeah.
I love Tucson.
This might be a little less busy. So the baby could be in there for a little bit.
They don't know. They're just saying, like, hours old baby. And so there was a custodian who found the baby. And they called 911 saying, like, hey, somebody left a newborn baby with a note in the bathroom.
So casual.
I want to know how many dudes went in there and they're like taking a piss and they're like, baby over there?
I don't think they'd be in that bathroom though, right?
Women's restroom.
Oh, women's restroom. Oh my.
Well, I want to hear your joke.
Well, no. It's like, they're going to the bathroom, right? Yeah. And then they come out and they're washing their hands. They're like, oh, is that a baby? Okay. You know what I mean? Just, and they're out of there.
Like, I would have done
that.
See
why.
That is guy mentality.
Yeah, that is.
Oh, it's guy mentality.
The guy's taking a piss or taking a shit or something.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, who's going to hold a baby while they're taking a shit?
Right.
So yeah, just leave the baby.
If they're covered in blood, though. Like, that's the part that gets me. It's like, I just feel like something's off here.
Would look at the baby and be like, oh, they're covered in blood.
Yeah, I can't get too close to a baby.
Guys are oblivious.
No, I wouldn't get that close because I'd be like, oh, what if the dad's like, hey, that's my baby. Oh, my bad.
That's what I mean. That's how we are.
I ain't trying to be all.
In a guy's bathroom, we don't want to look at fucking anything. We don't want to accidentally see dicks or anything. We just want to look right ahead.
Yeah, you look at the ceiling.
Up on this all axis right here.
That's it.
Or the ceiling.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
You know someone's shady when he's looking down.
Yeah, I'm out of there.
Hands in his pockets, looking down.
Oh, because he's looking at your dick, looking for dick.
While he's jacking off.
Oh, hands in the pocket, got it, shit.
Have you seen that?
No, but that's what I look out for.
Oh. Yeah. You look out for guys jerking off next to
you. With a trench coat?
You must think you're the most attractive man of all time.
Probably.
I never think someone's jerking to me, ever. I would never think that.
I don't know, man.
Oh,
it's just
dangerous. You need more confidence in yourself.
No, it's not a lack of confidence. I'm just like, why? You can do better. You'll do much better than me. Trust me.
You're like, I wouldn't.
There's more hairless men, you know, more attractive men, butt chins everywhere.
Everywhere.
You'll find
it's a manly trait.
Yeah.
Oh, that Walmart and this guy was in the shitter with like porn and like probably whacking off. And me.
Well, you can like hear it or like.
Yeah, just,
like,
and the guy, me and this guy was like washing hands and we did this thing where like, is that porn? And we're just kind of looking.
With the audio on and everything?
Yeah, it was like
the fuck?
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, and then we're just like.
Wait, where is this again? A Walmart?
Walmart.
And it would be in a Walmart.
Yeah, and then I walked out like, that's weird, man. Why would you do it here?
It's all dirty, gross.
Yeah.
Walmart bathroom.
Do you think he was an employee?
I don't know. I mean, I can't judge because I jacked off in public restrooms before.
You have?
But I never played porn loud. I'm respectful of other
Still
customers.
Played it. Still
and
played
I was like 13 or something. You know, like...
Like at school or something?
I think this was a grown man.
Huh? You could even play porn back then if you're 13. You didn't have a phone.
Exactly. So I was respectful.
But if
that
I did,
means you're lying.
If I did it today, yeah. I would use headphones or I would not put the volume up because I don't want to ruin people's shit or piss.
Dude, you could even hear the fucking skin.
Not my dick. It's small.
just a bunch of really quick like.
No, mine is not loud. I guarantee.
It's very Japanese.
Yeah, it's a ninja. It's a ninja. Yeah, yeah. And I'm uncircumcised, so that sleeve gives it that extra comfort.
Is that how that works?
Yeah, it's there's no extra sound. Yeah.
Man, Jess is so fucking lucky.
Yep. Oh, yeah. She caught a good one.
It's the feel and the cue.
Yeah, so the baby was taken to a hospital just to make sure it was okay. And is in the care of the Arizona Department of Child Safety. And Arizona, the cops are saying that they are not searching for the woman because the baby wasn't injured. And since Arizona is a safe haven state, they do allow parents who aren't unable to take care of newborns to surrender the babies in designated areas, which an airport is not.
I was about to say, like, isn't it like a hospital though?
Or yeah, hospitals or churches or fire stations.
So is she gonna get in trouble because she didn't do that?
She's not. So they're not even searching for the woman.
Poor baby.
Yeah, I always see like babies in a basket at fire stations, right? That's like the movie trope.
You see,
the
okay.
Yeah, that's the meme, babies in a basket, like yeah like penguin.
Yeah, what, is there a weird place that's legal?
Yeah, I don't know.
Is there a list of like other places?
I hope it's not.
Like a bakery. It's like you can always leave a baby in a bakery.
Even at Marie Callender's.
Little known.
Yeah, Marie Callender's.
Yeah, Coco's bathroom.
Maybe. Yeah, I just knew hospitals and fire stations.
Or police stations.
Oh, really?
Like government places, right?
Yeah.
I would have taken.
Not the DMV.
Oh no, the DMV. No one's gonna pick the baby up.
No.
Give him a number.
Everyone's so pissed there. They're like, oh, why's a baby here too?
Can somebody shut that kid up?
Yeah.
Baby cut in line in front of me, trying to get my registration.
It's crazy she didn't know she was pregnant.
I know, that's
but I've heard stories like that, right? Where they like just don't know and they just give birth.
Show about it, right? Like
I didn't know I was pregnant. In the name of the show.
It's because they're so fat.
Uh huh.
Yeah. That they don't even know.
She didn't look that fat.
In that one show, I remember seeing this one episode of this woman. She was like skinny, like tiny, and then there's photos showing.
And
like,
there's no baby.
This is when she was about 9 months pregnant.
Yeah, wow. I've seen that woman too.
Yeah, she was on like Montel, right, or Maury.
I don't know.
So what does the baby do? Just fucking push away all the organs and shit and just stay in that ab?
No, it's like how does the whole baby fit in
just
there?
Just a very flat baby.
Maybe just up against the wall like this.
Doing a Sam Fisher.
Respectful of her body. I think that's
Does that mean there's a point in the pregnancy where the baby's not even moving at all? Like she didn't go wait.
I know, because babies
like,
should
angry? Like yeah. What's
yeah.
going on?
Yeah.
I know that's I would think of all that too.
I don't know shit that. About this baby stuff. Yeah, it's crazy.
Would kick the shit out of my ribs.
Really?
Yeah.
Your ribs?
Yeah.
What does that feel like? That's gotta be
like what you would literally think it would feel like.
Did you get revenge?
Oh, yeah.
Punch back.
Immediately, as soon as he was born. How do you like that?
How do you like that?
Get revenge by drinking alcohol. Hey, yeah, baby.
No, never.
My grandma said that you should, if a kid's crying too much, you just take a little bit of, sorry, grandma, a little bit of gin and you put it on their pacifier.
I've heard that one before too.
See?
Yeah, I heard of that too.
But what if Taika has hella Asian glow? It's fucking all glowing all red and shit. Ah!
Damn, I didn't think of that.
The Asian thing was get a little bit of Tiger Balm or a lot of it and fucking wipe it on your eyelids.
Ow! Wouldn't that burn?
What does that do?
It forces you to close your eyes and go to sleep.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Sleep crying.
Are you serious or is that a joke?
No,
it's burning and shit.
You guys didn't get that?
No.
Asian style?
I think your parents hated you.
No. So like I wouldn't go to sleep and I'll be fucking hyperactive and shit. And she goes, you need to go to sleep now. I can't close my eyes. And she goes, this is how you close your eyes.
I like that. That's a good
did
trick.
It burn your eyelids?
Hell yeah. And then I never told my grandma again that I can't go to sleep. I would just pretend.
Oh no.
I'm sleeping, grandma.
Did you actually fall asleep that time?
Hell no, dude. I was fucking, I'm just like, though. I just closed my eyes, forcing myself to sleep.
Yeah.
Oh, shit!
So she did that only once.
It only took one time for me to learn my lesson.
That's like a spanking.
Yeah.
I got a spanking one time.
Spanking on the eyelids.
It took me multiple spankings. Spanking.
Did it?
Yeah. For an eternity.
Dude, one and I was over. It was done.
Was that supposed to be bad?
Tiger Bomb on the
roof? Yeah.
That's horrible.
It sounds like your grandma hated you.
I have great memories.
If he didn't get blind from it, then technically it's harmless.
You're the last person to talk.
No, because if there's no permanent damage, then it's just temporary pain.
You're the last
then it's
person.
Harmless.
No, you're not. You weren't raised by the same standards as the basic average person.
I mean, Joe's not blind. He can see.
But my eyes are so small. How do you think this happened? Fucking stunted my eye growth, man. Fuck. It's always closed now because I'm like, fuck, traumatized. Fuck you, Grandma. Nah, she's awesome.
Couldn't even stick the landing on that one.
Dude, I'm scared.
I get it.
She's gonna come back as a spirit. Hell yeah, dude.
I get it.
Dang, that's crazy.
I don't know if I could ever throw away a baby like that. It's crazy.
Yeah, I know, especially as a mama, I think it's even harder because like, oh, well, she didn't even know, so there is no attachment.
I say good for that lady, man. I mean it. I'm not even doing a shtick or anything. Like, good for her because she's like, yo, I can't do this. Yeah. And she had the baby, and she's like, I can't do it, man.
And she left it in a safe place, too. Like, she didn't leave it in, like, a dumpster or anything like that.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, what's with that, man? Like, I gotta throw the baby in a dumpster?
I've never been in that position, though, so.
That's oh, my God.
Or when they leave the babies in the toilet, like, they actually give birth in the
And they leave it.
In the toilet?
Yeah, man.
We talked about it on JK News. I think it was, like, in Asia.
Somewhere. Look for that koala brand. That's the safe place.
It's a safe haven.
Yeah.
Great place.
The blue koala, that's it.